Human Resources Board to order. It is 4:03, and present are Mark Blackman, Chair.
Anthony Antico.
Rick Harris.
John Lucy.
Diane Doyle.
John Ferraro is not with us this afternoon. I have not heard from John, but we do have a quorum, so let's move ahead. We've called the meeting to order, and first order of business will be to review the minutes from last month's meeting. Let's take a minute on that.
Move to accept.
A second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Minutes are accepted as written. Thank you, Diane. Those are minutes? Oh, we'll just work on it next week. Employee issues?
None.
Diane, nothing you've got?
There is a new position with the Council on Aging that's going to be having some changes, so we'll now need to call a classification subcommittee to review the job.
Is it a change in an existing role?
Yeah, it's a change in an existing role. So I'm going to be meeting with Maggie on Wednesday, so I'll reach out.
Likely need to be reclassified?
Yeah.
All right, then we'll, when that's ready to go, we'll call the classification subcommittee to order. Move that ahead. Sounds like it's pretty straightforward. Other than that, in terms of personnel actions, job vacancies, none that you're aware of? Discrimination and or ethics issues?
No.
Safety issues?
None.
All right, moving along to other business. I did take the opportunity to speak to Tracy last week in reference to the decision we've made to go ahead and kind of introduce ourselves into the various departments in town. And she has assured me again that there are no issues that she's aware of in advance that we need to be dealing with. We can feel free to, if we haven't already, make our introductions to the managers of those individual departments and ask if we can do anything from, you know, have an audience with he or she or the group, or you know, if nothing else, at least you make it clear to those who may already not be aware that we'd love to be a resource for them on an as-needed basis. We don't want it to be intrusive, certainly, but we are available to them as a resource, whether it's organizational issues or personnel issues or anything that might help move the ball forward with their department. So just as a reminder, it's been a couple of months since we reviewed this. Let me just go through the list of departments, and again, to the extent that you may not have already, you can feel free to now go ahead and introduce yourselves to those folks. John Lucy, you've got the accounting department and the library. Rick, the assessing department and the building department. John Ferrara has conservation and PD. I know you've already been engaged with John. Diane, the COA and the planning department. And I have the fire department, health department, and town clerk. Did we cover everybody?
Yeah, I have public works.
I'm sorry, public works. Only public works and IT.
IT.
Sorry, yeah. So, you know, as far as town administrator is concerned, it's full speed ahead. Feel free to do what we need to. Unless anyone objects, why don't I suggest we put this on the agenda for next month's meeting and ask everybody for a quick verbal report on what, if anything, has happened to date with that. I'll send out a reminder by email to the group about these assignments and just ask sometime over the next 30 days if we can make that initial introduction. If we haven't already, that might be a good idea.
Is the email addresses available on the website?
Well, even if you go to the website by department, they should be right there.
I think each department has a contact name. Mm-hmm. with information. I'm assuming that that contact name would be the department head. I'm not sure if that's the case with all departments, but.
Okay, and also I was just wondering, on building, we're talking about Sam, right, one person?
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, a number of these are one or two person departments, and chances are there won't be an awful lot to be done, but.
Yeah.
For those of us who may have, you know, multi-person departments, PD, fire department, such, then perhaps there'll be more opportunity to be of service, so. So we'll put that on the agenda for next month. And the only other thing I had, I was hoping to see Tracy today, I neglected to ask her this when we spoke last week, is whether whether we've heard back from town council on language changes that that I think were given to town council 45 days ago, a couple months ago, I think.
I'll check in with her.
Is that your understanding, Diane?
I'll check in with her.
Okay. Do we know when changes have to be official and put on the?
I'll check on the deadline for town meeting.
Yeah, town meeting warrant?
I haven't seen the request come through for town meeting warrant, so.
I mean, town meeting is up in less than a month, isn't it?
October 24th, yeah.
24th, so a month away, so.
I will check.
If you'd let me know on that, and if there's anything I need to be doing on it.
I'll email you.
Okay, thank you. Any other new business?
It's been pretty quiet.
Anticipated that. All right, well, with that in mind, let's look at the.
It's typical this time of year.
Calendar? Looks like Monday, October 23rd is our next scheduled meeting, it's the fourth Monday in October. Let's put that on calendars, and we'll assume that everybody's available for that. Again, as always, if you're traveling or unable to make it, please let me know. It's Monday, October the 23rd at 4 p.m. Okay? Done. Anything else?
Well, I have a question, it's not new business, but do, are there any plans for adding people? I know we talked about replacing people in fire department, any departments growing in this fiscal year?
I don't think so, not that I know of.
The only position I know is the town planner is gonna be hiring an assistant, like an admin assistant, but other than that, I'm not aware of any plans for additional.
Okay, just curious about where we are.
We look pretty well stable right now, we have all the positions filled. That's the only one I'm aware of, that, the change of the council on aging, but those are both minor.
A question, what's the total amount of employees in the system, number?
So we have about 50 to 55 full-time or part-time permanent employees covering the departments that he mentioned. And then we have about 70 on-call firefighters. So it's about 120 employees, but 50 full-time, permanent, part-time, and about 70 or so on-call firefighters that work.
I can confirm the number because I remember signing all of the personal notices. I was rather interested by the end of the afternoon. There was a bunch. What's that, Tom?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Okay, unless there's any other business to discuss, except a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Seconded?
I'll second it.
Yeah, we are adjourned.